Tell me about your G League experience, your one game, just domination down there.
It was good. Yeah. You know, needed it. See, not a lot of game reps, so, you know, as a basketball player, you just want to play basketball. That's what you grew up loving. So, you know, going back to it and kind of finding your rhythm, finding your confidence, just, you know, seeing where you're at and you're still where you want to be is important, you know. I go in the gym, grind every day, and, you know, you got to check yourself sometimes, go back and play. So it was an unbelievable experience, and I just want to shout out to the coaching staff out there because they handled it amazing. Like, you know, a guy goes in down there for the first time. I've never played with the guys, and coaching staff did everything for me to be comfortable, be myself, play as I want to play, and as well as the G League guys, you know. It's not easy when a guy comes down and has to play 30 plus minutes and, right, you know, you are there grinding too and playing, and some of the guys don't get a lot of playing time and, you know, the shots they usually take. So I just want to say thank you for them allowing me to go down there and just play how I play and, you know, having my back and supporting me. And
on top of all that, was it just fun?
It was, man, playing basketball is always fun. That's why, that's the main thing with me, man. Just put me out there. I don't care if it's YMCA or NBA game. You know, I'll just go out there and just hoop, man. And, you know, that competitiveness kick in without who, no matter who you play. So, you know, great. We got a dub, you know what I'm saying? And that felt great as well. And, overall, great experience.
Did you meet the Austin team in Frisco? Is that how it worked? Or did
you... I met the Austin team in Dallas. You know, I just flew down there a couple hours before the game, took a nap, and went straight to the game. So, yeah.
And when did you get here?
I got here last night at like 11. Okay. We drove from Dallas.
Drove?
Yeah, so, you know, long drive, but, you know, it was good.
Did you drive yourself or somebody drove
you? No, somebody drove me. If I drove myself, I would go crazy. You know, shout out to my girl surprising me. She came down, you know, surprised me during the game. So that was nice as well, yeah.
How's the NBA season gone for you? I guess you haven't got as many minutes as you kind of envisioned.
You know, I've been here. I've been, like, you know, with the Bucks, experienced similar thing. You know, sometimes, you know, things won't go the way you want. Just got to stay ready, stay motivated, work hard, you know. I'm lucky that I have a circle that I have off the court who always keeps me in check and motivates me and tells me to have faith. And nothing, you know, I believe in this organization. I love the organization. I love the team. So, you know, even though not playing, like, that doesn't take me out from the game for 1 second. Like, I'm as involved as I was on the court. So, you know, even though we're losing, I'm still with them. So,
you guys are killing me, man.
I'm sure, you know, we're going to figure it out no matter what's going on. I'm on the court. I'm not on the court. I'm sure, like, I always cheer for them, and I'm here and practicing with them. So, it's been great.
What does it take to stay ready? Because you never know when that
comes. So, first of all, it's mental game, man. Not a lot of people know that, but NBA is like 95% mental. You know, if you kind of break and you're done. And I feel like I learned that with the Bucks. You know, great veterans who kind of taught me to stay motivated and ready. And here as well, you know, great guys, great group of guys. Every time we play 3-on-3, 4-on-4, stay ready. And of course, extra work in that people don't see. You know, go in the gym at night and just take a bunch of shots and have fun and relax and just have that one-on-one gym, you know, session. So it always kind of keeps you in check as well. So just overall everything, you know, just staying in presence, staying where your feet at, and staying mentally ready is always kind of keeps you prepared for the game.
Did you see the shot you made off the rafters and at the practice site?
Oh yeah, that was a good one. I feel like I gotta, you know, that was a good one. I gotta shoot more trick shots after practice, you know. Yeah, for sure.
Awesome.